rate formation. So work out the height divided by 2.5 to get the centimetres in a flat building over the last 2,500 years. And of course, in that kind of soil, some beetles, more loving beetles, they find those intercourse samples are some of them living in the more or less date what was there at that moment in time. Now Sam Williamson does a similar thing with river beds and sediments, but he looks at the mineral content from, say, the natural minerals to those pollutants put down by man like lead, cadmium and so on over the years. He doesn't have a mineral polluted ion.
Lots of sphagnum, and sphagnum acidifies the environment. So as it takes in a mineral ion as part of its own nutrition, for example calcium, as that crosses the cell membrane to actually keep electrochemical neutrality in the cell, then proton, which is a hydrogen ion, is faulted out by the cell. So sphagnum actually over time acidifies its own environment, and the acid really does prevent decomposition of all the other plant remains, so you get peat formation.
Yeah. I don't talk about pH of